Yeah.
Wait on, sir.
Come in.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Please sit down.
Thank you, sir.
So, Mr. Kataria, you've left some big jobs, 7 lakh rupees, 2 lakh 50 thousand.
Yes, sir.
And you are seeking a job here, right?
Sir, after my graduation, I considered two options. Mm-hmm. One was to do a private sector job, another was to enter into the domain of civil services.
Mm-hmm.
So, after working for 3 years, I compared the two options once again. And I realized that civil services is a better option to realize my potential.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I'm coming towards civil services.
Why is it a better option?
Sir, I consider two parameters, namely job quality and job satisfaction which I'll be getting. I have an opportunity to interact with some senior IAS officers and a few of my friends and discuss with them with the various opportunities which I can have in civil services, and after a informed discussion with them, I decided to opt for civil services.
Okay. So what qualities will you bring to this job?
Sir, I am an optimist person who has a lot of belief in the democratic values which our country has. I also have empathy towards the poor, and I have a modern outlook which I will try to bring in the administration as well, so that I can affect it in a way it can improve going forward.
Right. So, is this your first attempt?
Yes, sir. I had one attempt in 2014, but that was mainly a precursory look for the preliminary examination.
Mm-hmm.
But this is my first attempt with full
preparation. First real attempt.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Are you familiar with the Constitution?
Yes, sir, I have read about it.
Where do you see the checks and balances in our constitution?
Sir, the entire constitution revolves around the idea of limited powers to be given and restricting the powers which are there. Each institution in our democracy, namely the legislature, judiciary and executive, they have some form of checks and balances over each other. So, such as we have Article 75, which talks about the collective responsibility of the Council of Ministers. Apart from that, we have the concept of judicial review through which the judiciary can examine the various laws which are constituted and test on the constitutional ideals which we have.
Does fundamental rights, do they limit the power of the government, executive and the legislature? No? Parliament?
Yes, sir. Fundamental rights, they are negatively connoted in the sense that they impose restrictions on the state and duties which and the powers which it shouldn't abrogate the rights of the individuals which are present in the democracy.
And what is judicial review?
Sir, judicial review is a mechanism through which the judiciary examines the various statutes which are present in a democracy, like various laws which are made or the executive orders which are given by the government.
What is the parameter on which it is touched on, which it is tested?
Sir, the judicial review is done on the constitutional ideas which you have, like the basic structure which has the ideas such as the independence of judiciary.
Correct. Basic structure.
Yes.
What is basic structure?
Sir, basic structure was a doctrine given by the Supreme Court in the Keshavanand Bharati judgment in 1973. So it is a set of ideals which the judiciary believes that which should not be abrogated by any amendment which is made in the constitution by the lawmakers.
Some of the basic, would you list some of the basic features, basic structure, best features which are construed to be basic structure?
Sir, we have separation of powers, then we have independence of judiciary, we need to follow rule of law.
Yeah, you're correct. Now, tell us, why do we need All India Services?
Sir, All India Services are formulated to provide a uniform administration across the entire country. They are a set of individuals who are selected through a an examination process which tests them over various aspects which are needed for a civil servant, and they are believed to have a diverse background through which they can strengthen the governance in our country.
Okay. Can you tell us about some of the features of Right to Education Act?
Sir, Right to Education talks about free and compulsory education to the...
That is Article 21A.
Yes, sir.
That's already there, but yes, how... That is the law which guarantees it, and how it has been implemented? It has been implemented through RTE Act.
Yes, sir.
What are the provisions? How do we implement it and make that right a reality?
Sir, there are various checks which school needs to follow in terms of infrastructure quality which is to be given to the students. Then we need to have a particular pupil to teacher ratio which needs to be maintained. Apart from that, there was a recent provision of no detention which has been recently removed. Apart from that, there needs to be a school within the locality of the student so that more accessibility to the
students. To this is even private sector schools are included.
Yes, a private sector
schools. There is a reservation.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, last, can you tell us about the laws which and the institutions which we have set up to deal with terrorism?
Sir, there is National Intelligence Agency.
National Investigation.
NIA. And there is an NIA Act for that. Then there is FIU, Financial Intelligence Unit, which looks into the financial transactions. Then there are various forces, police forces, which
and
are
the law that can be invoked against terrorists.
So there is National Security Act. There is Unlawful Activities Prevention Act.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You were coordinator for your placement team.
Yes, ma'am.
So what exactly did you do?
Ma'am, I contacted various companies which were allotted to me by the placement managers. My job was to get in touch with them and ask them to visit the placement process in IIT Bombay.
Okay. So you've also written that you were teaching, you were a teaching assistant.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, very often we hear this term that even the IIT graduates are not employable.
Yes,
why is that so? Do you think they lack in some skill? Since you were a teacher, you would know.
And there is a industry academia gap in the country right now, because of which students they do not get the adequate level of skills which are needed for various firms. So there are various cases like firms hiring a lot of graduates and then providing them mentorship or orientation sessions for 6 months or longer duration so that they get the required skills that they which are relevant to the firms. So there is definitely a gap which needs to be filled.
Okay. Now, you heard of the term demographic dividend?
Yes, ma'am.
What does this mean, demographic dividend?
Ma'am, it implies a transition in a society where the age structure helps in the overall growth.
How?
Of the economy. Ma'am, when the number of people who are working in the age group, who are in the working age group, they are high, they are able to contribute more, and their dependency ratio, such
yes,
as
dependency
the,
ratio. But then if they are not really skilled, then what happens?
Demographic dividend will turn into a disaster which needs to be avoided.
And if they are skilled and they don't have jobs, again there will be a problem?
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You've also written interest or hobby as traveling.
Yes, ma'am.
Which are the cities you visited in your state in the last 1 month or 2 months? Have you visited any other state other than where you are living?
Ma'am, I had visited Sirohi recently, but apart from that I haven't travelled a lot in recent times.
Okay, in the last 1 year? You've been travelling, so you should be able to say something.
Yes, I haven't been travelling a lot in the last 1 year. I have had occasional visits for various reasons, but not for travel per se, because of my examination process.
Okay, alright, because of your exams, you were studying. So what did you see in Sirohi? What's so important?
Ma'am, Sirohi is famous for its swords, and it is a relatively less developed district which is bordering the state of Gujarat. So I just went there for a one day visit to meet my friend.
All right. Now you were also working as a data scientist.
Yes,
what
ma'am.
Does this mean, data scientist?
Ma'am, data scientist was the official designation given to me, but being as the company was a startup, so my role was a lot more diverse. Apart from data scientist, I also worked as a software developer.
Okay, so we hear this term big data.
Yes,
what
ma'am.
Is big data?
Ma'am, big data refers to a large quantity of data, which is generally defined by three V's, that is velocity. It can be, it is fastly available, then variety, there is a lot of information, not restricted to a particular.
Why are we not talking of data localization? Any reason?
Well, recently there have been issues about various data leaks and the misuse of data. And in order to investigate them properly, the government needs to have quick access to the data without any hurdles by the laws which are present. That is why if the data is available locally, then we can utilize the local laws well. Otherwise, we need to have interaction with the foreign government where the data is present in order to get access to the data.
Okay, you're from Jaipur.
Yes, ma'am.
And Jaipur is one of the cities which is to be made a smart city.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you know what a smart city project is?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me something about it.
Ma'am.
What are its components?
Smart city project as a whole, it would decide.
How many cities?
There are 100 cities all over India.
Yes.
And in Rajasthan there are 4 cities.
Mm-hmm. Which are the 4? You studied in 2 of them?
Yes, ma'am. Kota, Jaipur, Ajmer. I am not able to recall.
Is Jodhpur one of Udaipur?
Yes, mostly it is Udaipur. I am not sure.
All right. So tell me, what are the components? How will we make a city smart?
So smart city believes in integrating the information and communication technology into the government structure and improving the efficiency of service delivery. Apart from that, there are also components of improving the present infrastructure which is present.
And why do we need smart cities?
Then smart cities help in better urban planning as well as effective.
Because a large number of people are now migrating to the cities.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Mr. Kanish,
yes, sir.
How to describe the state of the Indian economy at the moment? Short term.
So short term status, I will say that our economy is recovering. And it is the fastest growing economy in the
country. Can you give some numbers, macro numbers, if you have?
So we have recently had a 7.1% GDP growth rate in last year. Apart from that, our overall macroeconomic fundamentals are quite strong. The inflation is in control. It is hovering around 2-3%. Apart from that, the
fiscal deficit
is 3.4%. And the government is continuously.
We have already crossed the target, right?
Yes.
Target was 3.3.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of expenditure is in the pipeline.
Yes, sir.
And that's a matter of concern, you think so?
Sir, it has both positives as well as negative sides. Because R is a developing economy, we need some form of expenditure made by the government to boost up, especially given the overall investment scenario.
But you will make expenditure only if your resources permit.
Yes, sir. So that is a negative aspect of it, but given the push which is needed by the economy, it is an inevitable decision which the government made.
What happens if the fiscal deficit target is exceeded? What is the consequence of it?
Sir, there are consequences like the foreign credit rating agencies, they degrade the sovereign ratings.
Absolutely.
Apart from that, there is also possibility of inflation and the crowding out effect.
So these are serious consequences.
Yes, sir.
And on the international trade, on the balance of payments also, there are some issues of concern, short term.
Yes, sir. It depends a lot on the state of the crude oil, which is the prices of crude oil in the global economy. So we had concerns in the month of
October. There are one or two developments which might harden the oil prices internationally.
Yes, sir.
What are they?
Sir, recently there has been a crisis in Venezuela which can have an impact, and apart from that, the strengthening of Iran sanctions by USA, it can affect the Indian economy.
Are there any medium term concerns the economy should be concerned about? Medium?
Sir, we need to improve the credit structure in the economy, especially the banking problem which is there. If we can improve that, then medium term growth can be sustained. Also, we need to hedge against the increasing the high dependence which we have on the crude oil, which
unemployment.
Unemployment is another problem in the economy right now, and certainly in order to improve the to utilize the demographic dividend, we need to provide as much employment as possible.
Rajasthan, we are from Rajasthan. There's a lot of development regarding labor law reforms in Rajasthan. Are you aware of that?
Yes,
can throw some light on that.
Sir, Rajasthan was one of the states.
How important is these reforms and what has been done in the state?
Sir, recently Rajasthan increased the amount of work, the number of workers, the threshold for which the companies need permission for the from the government for retrenchment.
Under what law?
And these laws are very important because the labor market is a very critical, important in any industry.
Yeah.
And
apart from industrial issues, are there any other labor law that has been contract labor, for example?
I'm sorry, sir, I'm not
ready. Okay. Last question. What is, in two sentences, what is the problem of Brexit and where the matters rest today?
So Brexit was a the referendum done by the British government to exit the European Union, and it was voted in favor of exiting the Union. However, a deal hasn't been successfully negotiated till date between the terms of trade, the exit by the
British government. What is withholding? What is it?
So there is an Irish backstop agreement with regards to the hard border between Northern Ireland and Republic of Ireland. So.
What is latest on that?
So from what I last read, the Theresa May government wasn't able to pass the deal, and they are trying to negotiate a better deal with the European Union.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
So you're fond of cricket and tennis.
Yes, sir.
Name some important achievements in the field of cricket recently.
Sir, the Indian cricket team is amongst the best team in the world right now. And it is number one in the test rankings. It recently won a test series in Australia for the first time. Apart from that, in ODI cricket also, Indian team is number two, and in T20 cricket as well. So overall, last 1 year has been challenging for Indian cricket because of away tours, but it has done very well.
In tennis, who are the reigning champions?
Sir, in Australian Open, Novak Djokovic. In French Open, Rafael Nadal. In Wimbledon and US Open, again, Novak Djokovic is the defending champion.
Okay. You have done computer science.
Yes, sir.
So, when we talk of IoT, is it part of a computer? Internet of Things?
Yes, sir. It is related to the overall ecosystem.
What is the role of IoT in India? In which areas we are using it now?
Sir, IoT can be integrated with the smart cities project, especially...
Can be integrated. I'm saying which is currently the use, current applications.
Sir, I don't know the exact use where it is right now.
Alright. What is artificial intelligence?
Sir, artificial intelligence is providing intelligence to a machine through which it can take some intelligent actions.
So, what are the current applications in India?
Sir, like the robotics industry, it has been given being given a push, which uses artificial intelligence. Apart from that,
robotics is artificial intelligence.
Sir, the back end of it derives from artificial intelligence.
But it doesn't have an intelligence of its own.
Yes, so we need to provide it using a software.
You said robotics. Today, robots are controlled from the ground.
But
correct or not?
Yes, sir.
So, whereas artificial intelligence will make a machine think on its own.
Yes, sir.
So, how do you say that robotics is part of artificial intelligence?
Sir, there are various modules such as natural language processing, which can be integrated into robots, which helps them understand the speech recognition.
So the functions which it will perform,
functionalities
will be controlled by artificial intelligence. That's what you're saying.
Yes, sir.
What is the policy, India's policy on robots?
I'm sorry, sir.
Have we introduced robots anywhere?
So recently there was a report in a global entrepreneurship summit which was inaugurated by PM Modi, mm-hmm. and there was a report called Mitra, from what I recall.
Okay. Is drone a part of artificial intelligence?
Yes, sir. Sir, drones can fly over the territories which are hitherto inaccessible. They can analyze the ground realities through imagery, and they can.
It is like a camera.
Yes, sir. But
you don't say camera has intelligence. No.
But the softwares which process the image processing which is being done.
It's doing image processing also there in the air, or it's only sending the images to the ground. Processing is done in on the ground.
Yes, the processing is done on the ground. Okay. Yes.
You know the drone policy, India's drone policy?
Yes, sir. Recently it was updated regarding the limits where people can fly drones.
Who will control the drones in India? Which agent, authority?
So it is the Director General of Civil Aviation.
Correct, very good. Up to what weight no permit is required?
I'm sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall the exact
number. Mobile telephony. You think in this field, manufacturing of mobile phones, can we see some green shoots in the field of Make in India?
Yes, sir. Make in India can benefit a lot with the smartphone.
I'm trying to ask you a question. Has the manufacturing of mobile phones taken root in India so that we can take, we can claim that yes, it is part of our Make in India project?
Sir, there are various firms which are now setting up their production units inside India, such as Apple, which is targeting output unit in the southern India. Apart from that,
Apple is doing it in India. Has it been granted the license?
I'm sorry, sir, I'm not able to. I don't know the latest development on it, but I have read it in the news. That
Is Samsung producing mobile phones in India?
So from what I recall, it is not.
It is not?
I'm not sure.
But then the companies which have come up in Noida, what are those?
Sir, they are producing the parts and working on the specifically the semiconductors which are being developed. But the whole scale integrated assembly line production of the entire smartphone, I'm not sure it is being done in India right now to a very big extent.
Have you heard of Jan Arogya Yojana?
Yes, sir.
It was launched in September 2018.
Yes, sir.
How many families will it cover? 10 crore.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
What are the initial results till now? Have people started taking benefit of it? Is it seems to be succeeding?
Yes, sir. The recent developments have been positive. And
any idea how many people have benefited so far?
Sir, around 3,000 crore is the benefits which have been claimed. I'm not sure the exact number of people who have enrolled. And
3,000 crores.
The claims which have been made against the insurance.
Only 1,000.
I'm sorry, sir.
1,000.
Yes.
3,000 crore is a huge amount. Insurance companies will go bust. Now, what is 10th schedule, 9th and 10th schedule in the constitution?
Sir, the laws which are placed in 9th schedule, they are against, they are outside the purview of judicial review.
And 10th schedule?
10th schedule talks about the anti-defection law.
Very good. You were in Korea?
Yes, sir.
For how many years?
So 1.5 years.
1.5. What you see in what have you seen in Korea, which you would like India to emulate and practice?
So one is discipline. The people which the discipline which people have and their hardworking mentality. Apart from that, innovation is given a big push by the government, as well as the education has been very successful. So these are few sectors which can be emulated even in India.
Are they more honest than Indians? In India, every shopkeeper tries to cheat you. What has it been your experience while shopping, etc.?
Sir, my experience was really good. It was mainly because of the ICT integration which they have. So entire the payment system was cashless.
All auto.
Completely automated cashless system was present.
Right. I'll ask you last question. What do you understand by autonomous weapons? Have you heard of this expression, autonomous weapons?
Yes, sir. I have heard.
Autonomous military weapons, let's say.
Yes, sir. I have heard. I'm not aware of the exact functionality.
Alright. Check up. They are artificial intelligence controlled weapons.
Thank you, sir.
Which don't need to think, they act on their own. We close the interview here.
Thank you.
I'll give you a feedback. Mr. Kataria, you've done very well. Most of the questions you've been able to handle nicely. Qualities, where qualities are concerned, empathy, optimism are good, but they are not enough. You have to say that you have integrity, you are diligent, you are decisive, you have moral courage, and you believe in rule of law, professional competence, and you are willing to handle responsibilities and crisis. These are the qualities required by these jobs. Now, we feel that most of the questioning will be based on your biodata. So since you are from Rajasthan, that is one area where you should prepare yourself well. Its economy, its social problems, areas of progress like tourism, solar power, wind power, labor reforms, etc. Then mathematics is your, so some questions you should also anticipate, like who are the greatest mathematicians in the world, or who have been, and who are the greatest mathematicians in India and what has been their contribution, something like this. What are these Fields Medal and Abel Medal, you know that? Or kis kis na jeete hain. Then computer science is an important thing on which you prepare some very functional intelligence and their applications in India. Then mobile telephony, since you have done this, it says, this is a very hilarious, made in India but imported, all phones, made in India but imported from China. So then lastly, constitutional principles. We have asked you a number of questions, judicial review, fundamental rights, etc. And current affairs. In current affairs, please include important issues which are pending before Supreme Court currently, like Lokpal, NRC, etc. Okay? For us, pay attention to these areas. And of course your hobbies. Certainly you will get questions on your hobbies. Otherwise you are doing very well, you have a nice personality, everything is in your favor. Huh?
Thank you.
Good luck.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.